I am just helping them hold that space to make that awareness, that experience more heightened. If I can do that, that's awesome.
I think just having an audience know that it's an ensemble, you know, like for us, having the audience know that we're a collective, you know, this, and they, you know, if they have questions, people say, well, how did you correct collectively write it? No. You know, give it to collective project? No. We can explain it to them, but the fact that they know it's a collective and they know it's an ensemble tweaks their vision of what's possible in a society that's increasingly, it's about the individual, individual. Saying, well, this is an ensemble. I think sometimes that's just that.
Right. And what I think the way you're putting it is sort of it's life and it's death, and it's not, and in saying that's just sort of part of what you're giving up, mm-hmm. as opposed to the big thing, which, and emotionally, I get what you were saying before, where it was like, we sweated an excellent process with each other for a long time, but you can't really share that other than through what the performance is and by saying, hey, it's a collective, and maybe sometimes inviting people in at certain points mm-hmm. to perhaps offer feedback. But there's a whole thing that happens privately within the company that just doesn't get shared, and it sort of has to kind of be wonderful on its own or awful on its own or whatever.
I actually disagree. Yeah. It is that unseen gospel thread that holds an ensemble together, but that actually is what the audience is witnessing. Mm-hmm. That's what they're coming to see. That's what they want to be in the space with. I think it's wonderful that, you know, I would want to, you know, I want to be there on opening because it's the future.
And that experience of ensemble, that there's something intangible about that that the audience senses. Question: if the language starts to get to be a problem here, but if we're talking about product, or I the product is even getting to be, but if I didn't know it was an ensemble, would I sense it? And does that contribute to the excellence of the experience? And are there sort of two parts of it? Is it there's something about it that feels ensemble-y, and also it's a really good show?
Not just cast them and get them to the other line, but they kind of have to fall in love with the process, they have to fall in love with what you're doing. So that by the time it opens, they're just as passionate about it. It's not just a gig, you know, because they are now part of something and not just in something. That's its own struggle. Mm-hmm. But it's fun.
We're at time, but I just have one more question.
It's so fast.
Really fast. And it goes to this notion of if the product is the process, is it disingenuous to open a show? I mean, like is that?
Then your process, unfortunately, can go on forever. Back in the 80s, ACT was doing some shows, Lear, I think it was. And a company from Moscow came to see what they were doing. And they were like, how long have you been working on this? And they were so happy that this is in the days when you had an 8-week rehearsal period.
Remember that?
That 8-week rehearsal period. Yeah. And the company, the Soviet company, said, you've been working on this for 8 years. They had just done Hamlet. They hadn't opened yet. And they'd been working on it for 2 years on a show that was done. They were like, how can you possibly do Shakespeare and work on it for less than 2 years? You know, and you're going, that's funding.
Next section, so hopefully we can pick up here and keep the conversation going. Please, do I have to divide the group?
Yes, Mark.
Great. So I'm going to ask you all to do that. Like this half here can stay in this room, and this half there can go to the space next door.
Yes, exactly. Thank you all so much.